Welcome back to ATS Recap. I'm your host, Brian.
And I'm Joe. And today in history, it's 1902 and the first motion picture theater opens in Los Angeles.
Glad to be here, Post. FBI's entrapment scheme exposed by suspect, so they grabbed him the very next day. 34-year-old Khalifa Al-Akali emailed The Guardian and local Muslim civil rights groups saying he was the target of an FBI entrapment sting. A couple days later, he's arrested and charged with illegal possession of a gun. And it didn't help that he had previous felony convictions for drug dealing. At his court appearance, an FBI agent testified against him, saying he made radical Islamic statements and had unspecified jihadist literature at home. What happened was, two men approached Khalifa. One wanted him to purchase a gun. The other offered to help him get to Pakistan for radical Islamic training. Khalifa believed that both of these men were FBI agents, which is then why he sent the emails. The FBI monitored his phone and emails, and once Khalifa identified one of the agents, he was arrested. Now he's denied bail as a potential threat to the public. JudgeDeath gives us a likely scenario. FBI, what is this? Stooge, my Quran? FBI, you're under arrest for possession of jihadist literature. What do you think happened in this case? If this Khalifa guy had no bad intentions whatsoever, then why would the FBI want to keep him locked up? Could it be because they screwed up and don't want to recognize it? You guys know where to comment. Joe, give us the next threat.
Anuki 10 is the author of our next threat. Sheriff Joe Arpaio gives U.S. Selective Service Director Larry Romo 30 days. Yup. The sheriff is asking the agency to conduct an investigation of Barack Obama's Selective Service Registration form from 1980. The sheriff feels strongly that the form is a forgery due to some inconsistencies on the form, specifically the incomplete date stamp. Sheriff investigators were able to replicate the alleged forgery by obtaining a circa 1980 pick a stamp and a circa 2008 date plug. Investigators were able to clearly demonstrate the 80, which should have read 1980 in Obama's Selective Service Registration form, resulted from cutting the 08 from an authentic 2008 date plug and inverting the 08 to read 80, and then was loaded back into the slot. Mudbeed writes, good luck with that, Joe, ya kook. AJ59 writes, some of you seem to be forgetting the authority of we the people. Sheriff Joe is but one of we the people who is willing to do our job. If you disagree with this concept, then all I can say is obviously you're not one of we the people. All right, Brian, give them our next thread.
Truth in fact authors, child witnesses to Afghan massacre say Robert Bales was not alone. There's two versions of what happened the night of March 11th. The Army version, and then the account of what child witnesses provided. Here's the Army version. Staff Sergeant Robert Bales left camp drunk with a pistol and an automatic rifle. He killed six people as they slept. Then he returned to the base and went back out and killed another 11 people. The Army says he acted alone and admitted to the killings. Now the surviving witnesses version. Children saw other Americans holding flashlights in the yard during the rampage. One child says her dog was shot, then her father was shot, then she was shot in the leg. The child also said one American was in the room while there were 15 to 20 others in the yard with lights on their weapons and headlamps on. Village elders also say several soldiers took part and that helicopters were overhead. TKDRL says, hate to say I told you so. Your maker thinks the better question for a conspiracy site would be something like this. Was Robert Bales even there? Was he KIA months ago when now they're using his identity to push an open black ops? Which version do you believe? There'd be a lot more strain in the relationship if it was known that other soldiers were involved.
Judas brings us our next thread. Fabrice Mumba, racist Twitter user jailed for 56 days. Right or wrong? First off, Fabrice is a footballer for the Bolton Wanderers. In a match against Tottenham Hotspurs, Fabrice collapsed mid-game due to cardiac arrest. Now, Liam Stacey, a student at Swansea University, admitted to inciting racial hatred over remarks about Fabrice. The district court judge John Charles called Liam's remarks vile. Then he goes on to say, in my view, there is no alternative to an immediate prison sentence. I think it's important to remember, think before you tweet. TruthWizard writes, wrong! Sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will land my ass in 21st century remix. Rising Against writes, why on earth should the abuser not face punishment for his idiotic behavior? Racism is racism, no matter where you do it, and it's always wrong and should always face punishment, in my opinion.
That's the episode. Is Sheriff Joe a kook? Yeah. Does the FBI entrap and set up stings on others? I think so. Did Robert Bales act alone? I doubt it. Chat with us on Twitter and Facebook. Click the like button if you like the video. We'll see you all next time. I'm Brian.
And I'm Joe, signing off.